Yo, hello there, happy whatever day of the week it is that you're watching this. I'm currently in Australia not always, I travel a fair bit, but over the summer I like to stay here because it's the best place ever, except for the past few days it's been raining and cold, hence the jumper and the tracksuit pants. And yes, I wear everything up around my belly button to keep me warm. I asked you guys on Instagram a day or two ago to send me some Q&As that you would like me to answer, and I wrote them all down. This is my book, and if I forget to write anything in my book, I will completely forget to do it. But lucky for you, I wrote it down, and so I have a whole bunch of questions that you guys want me to answer, and I'm going to do my best to get through as many of them as I possibly can. All right, question number one. How do I pronounce my name? If you can't say my name, you can just call me SJ, but my actual name is Sianna. So if you're Australian, it rhymes with banana, but if you're American, it doesn't rhyme with banana. It's not Sianna, it's Sianna, like piranha or sultana.
Oh, I'm gonna have to go through these and cross them off.
Am I planning on writing a book? I would love to publish a book. I'm writing a few. But I get like 30 sentences in and then I lose track and I start a different one. So I've got like five going and they're not like fictional or anything like that. They're all more like self-help books, I suppose, or some of my writings and stuff like that I've written. So hopefully one day I want to publish a book, and hopefully maybe even in the next couple of years. I know it takes a while to publish a book, but that is on the cards and that is one of my goals. Yes, I will do it. What was teaching my first yoga class like? It was scary as hell. I was pretty much pooping my pants and I weed myself just a little bit. No, I didn't really, but I probably could have because I was that scared. And then once I started, it wasn't that bad at all. It was more just like I'd had an exact plan written down of exactly what I wanted to do. And I was so scared of like missing something that I was like glued to that the whole time. And then now I write out lists of things that I'm going to do and I barely look at it. So, you know, you get used to it, and eventually it just kind of grows on you and it starts to feel more natural. I look back at classes that I did even like a month ago and I'm like, what was I thinking compared to now? And then I'll look back a month from now and be like, what was I thinking now? So yeah, constantly growing, but it's very, very fun and rewarding once you start to feel comfortable doing it. So if you're a new yoga teacher, keep doing it and you will get there, I promise. Pinky promise. Is my tan real or do I fake tan? My tan is 100% real all the time. I travel a lot to chase the sunshine because I love it so much. It makes me feel so happy. Like, I can't actually explain to you or to anyone just how good sunshine makes me feel. Like, I could literally be dead and it would bring me back to life. That's how good the sunshine is. And in Australia, it's kind of part of our way of life, really, like beach culture. So a tan is a side effect of that. What happened to my last relationship? Well, in summation, we broke up. But we're still really good friends. What brings me the most joy? Ooh, good question. So many things come to mind when that question pops up. Like family, spending time with loved ones, yoga, sunshine, like I said, the beach, just salt water, being in nature. But I think ultimately what makes me happiest is being around other people who are happy, or making other people happy. Like, if you see someone else smile and their smile, all of a sudden, like, you realize that you're smiling as well because they're happy, that's the best feeling ever. And I think that's what, I don't know, truly I think that's what life's all about. Call me lame, I know. Fave bands and music. I don't really know many bands or the names of songs or the lyrics to songs. I make them up, but I do love singing. Not that I should, because I'm not very good at it at all, but I will. Again, I shouldn't, but I will. And if I am, I always like acoustic covers are probably the best. And Ed Sheeran. Ed Sheeran's just, like, if I had one person in the whole world that I could meet and would probably lose my shiz over, it would be Ed Sheeran. I wouldn't even know what to say. Like, I would just want to like stare at him, which would be really awkward in a conversation. Like, if he was like, hey, how are you? And I was like, you know what I mean? But I bet he wouldn't even care. He'd probably just think it's funny and laugh. Again, another reason why I love it. Ed Sheeran, you're the best. High five. Woo! Weirdest, funniest fan experience. I don't think I have a weird or funny fan experience because I am not someone to have fan experiences. Like, I like it if people come up to me and they're like, hey, I recognize you from Instagram or something like that, but I wouldn't call that a fan experience because I don't consider myself someone to have fans. And if I did, I would feel like I was really egotistical. So I just don't like to think of it like that. So when people come up and say hi, but that's not weird at all. I like it. So come up and say hi. Give me a hug. Give me a big squeeze. My biggest fear. My biggest fear would probably be failure. I guess that's my biggest fear. And cockroaches. Petrified of cockroaches. They're just so creepy and crawly. Like spiders. Oh, I didn't like that spider that I found in my house one time. But like, I'm not, like I don't have like a phobia of spiders. They're just quick and they're creepy because they're like, bleh! But I don't want to kill them either. I just want to get them not near me. What exercises do I do? I do a lot of yoga, yes. I would do yoga every day. And then I run, like I said, whenever I feel, a couple of times a week maybe. And my runs aren't really runs. I run down the hills. And sometimes on flat surfaces, but normally I just run down the hills. And then the rest of the time I walk. But like, I like walking fast. My pet peeve, one of my pet peeves, is slow walkers. Specifically being stuck behind a slow walker. I don't really do anything else intentionally. So like, I'll go surfing and I'll take the dogs for walks and like maybe go hiking every now and then through Glen Rock or go for beach walks down to the other end where it's a little bit quieter. Yeah, like I sometimes do some laps in the pool. Or like just play around with the dogs or on the trampoline in mum and dad's backyard when I'm up there. But that's all kind of like unintentional exercise. I don't actually specifically go, I'm gonna go and work out right now. Because that's never really been a thing of mine. Like even when I was really sporty when I was little, the fact that I had to go to training, I hated it. I hated it. But if you'd let me do anything at home, I would have been like running around the house anyway. So. Like, I love moving my body, but mentally, I hate the thought of having to do something. So if it's fun, then it's super simple. And I think that's what exercise should be, to be honest. So unless you really like going to the gym, don't force yourself to do it. Find something that you prefer to do. Just saying. Do I count calories? No, I do not. I never have, and I never will. I hate maths. And so I don't see why you should make eating maths. It makes no sense to me. Like, you should do the minimal amount of maths possible in life. What form of yoga do I practice? I practice vinyasa. Half the stuff I do isn't even yoga. Like, I do like random dance moves and stuff in there. Do you want to see my recent one? So this is a jellyfish. Come to my classes, you'll love it. And then we do the car sound puppet. My life motto, just that everything happens for a reason and that if something's meant to be, eventually it will be. So I guess just trusting in the universe and in yourself, really. Yeah, knowing that even if something bad happens, you can grow from it, you can strengthen from it. How tall am I? I am 175 meters tall. Which means that I'm 5'9", if you're speaking in feet. How do I not have tan lines? Well, I mean, I do have little ones, but I always wear the skimpiest bikinis possible because I'm obsessed with good bikinis. And I'm a bikini connoisseur. I can't say that word, but you know what I mean. Fave activewear brands. I only have one favorite activewear brand, and you will all know what it is. It's Aloe Yoga. It is all I wear. All day, every day, pretty much. Like even this, it's not technically activewear, but it's Aloe Yoga. And they're the best things ever. Like comfiest pants. They can double as yoga pants or just around the house kicking it off. This is Aloe Yoga, this is Aloe Yoga. You know what I mean? What did I study? Well, I left school in year 10 because of my depression, mental health at the time. Wasn't really capable of going to school. Was in hospitals for a while, so kind of had too much leave away from school. My mum found an alternate way that I could get into university, so I did a stat exam, got to uni when I was 16, went to uni when I was 16, and studied initially a Bachelor of Arts, which is pretty much whatever you want because it's so broad and it's kind of what you do. Like I did a Bachelor of Arts because I didn't know what I wanted to do and I just had to do something to stay productive and self-disciplined. So that's what I did. I was doing like psychology, which was really interesting. I was doing German. I failed German. I know I'm really bad with languages. It's like maths. Maths is a language, hence why I'm bad at languages. Failed German. Photography, I did marine biology for a semester. Just, yeah, different random things that kind of made no sense collectively. And then I found out that I loved photography. I always knew that, but I didn't ever think about studying it. And where I was at Newcastle Uni, it was limited. So I moved up to Queensland, to Griffith University on the Gold Coast, and studied photojournalism at Griffith. So that was kind of fun, except I didn't like it, to be honest. Like, I think it was good that I did it because I needed to be doing something at the time. But doing an artistic or creative subject at university to me makes no sense because they tell you what's right and what's wrong and it should be open to interpretation. It should be objective and like who is one tutor or one person to tell you that this is right and that's wrong. I didn't agree with that, just personally. So I didn't finish. I did 3 years and then deferred indefinitely and never went back. All right, kids. I think that's pretty much it for now. I'm sorry this video has been so long. And thanks for watching. Hopefully I answered a couple of your questions. And if not, feel free to send me more and I can always do another question and answer video. Love you. Mwah!